కొన్ని అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్ కూడా వామ్ థింగ్స్ చేసుకుంటూనే వెళ్ళాం. బట్ ఐ నెవర్ ఫీల్ ఇట్స్ ఎన్ ఆఫ్. అంటే నేను ఆ ఎనర్జీ లెవెల్స్ తగ్గినట్టు కూడా అనిపించలేదు నాకు. సో అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్కి వెళ్ళిన తర్వాత మధ్యలో ఇంకా ఇంటర్మీడియట్ క్యాంప్ ఉంటుంది. సో దెర్ ఇస్ 6 క్యాంప్స్ అన్నమాట. సో అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్కి వెళ్ళగానే దే పుట్ ఆక్సిజన్ సిలిండర్ ఫర్ 1 అవర్. ఆ 1 అవర్ నాకు వామిటింగ్స్ అవ్వలేదు. ఎందుకంటే హై ఆల్టిట్యూడ్కి వెళ్తున్న కొద్దీ ఆక్సిజన్ లెవెల్స్ డౌన్ అవుతూ ఉంటాయి, నా బాడీ తట్టుకోవట్లేదు దానికి. సో ఆక్సిజన్ పెట్టినంతసేపు ఐఎమ్ ఓకే, దెన్ ఆక్సిజన్ 1 అవర్ తర్వాత తీసేశారు, మళ్ళీ వామిటింగ్ చేసుకున్నా వెంటనే. సో మళ్ళీ కిందికి పంపించారు బేస్ క్యాంప్కి. సో అప్పుడు అన్నారు ఒక షెఫ్ అనిచ్చి నన్ను కిందికి పంపించేసారు. అప్పుడు అన్నారు ఒక 2-3 డేస్ అక్కడ ఆ క్లైమేట్కి ఉండి మళ్ళీ పైకి రా, అడ్జస్ట్ అయ్యి మళ్ళీ పైకి రా అని చెప్పేసి అన్నారు. సో అప్పటికి నువ్వు మళ్ళీ అట్లనే వామిటింగ్స్ చేసుకుంటే ఇంకా నువ్వు ప్యాకప్ అన్నావు ఎక్కనీయమన్నారు. ఎందుకంటే మన ప్రాణంకి రిస్క్ అన్నమాట. సో అయినా కానీ అంతే చేశాను. బట్ ఆ 2-3 డేస్ తర్వాత మళ్ళీ పైకి వచ్చాను. దెన్ జనరల్గా అందరూ 7,300 మీటర్స్ నుండి ఆక్సిజన్ సిలిండర్ యూజ్ చేస్తారు. నాకు వచ్చేసి 6,900 మీటర్స్ సంథింగ్ ఆ లెవెల్ నుండి ఆక్సిజన్ పెట్టేసారు ఇంకా అన్నాడు. సో అదొక ఇన్సిడెంట్. నా ఎవరెస్ట్ జర్నీలో టఫెస్ట్ పార్ట్ వచ్చేసి అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్ నుండి క్యాంప్ 1కి వెళ్ళడం. అది ఎలా ఉంటుందంటే ఇట్ వాజ్ లైక్ వెరీ స్టీప్ లైక్ వాల్, చాలా ఘోరంగా ఉంటుంది మొత్తం. అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్ నుండి స్టార్ట్ అవుతే అంటిల్ యూ రీచ్ టు క్యాంప్ 1 అది మొత్తం గోడలానే ఉంటుంది. సో అది లైక్ జనరల్గా
బేస్ క్యాంప్ అంటే 5,300 మీటర్స్
బేస్ క్యాంప్ 5,300 మీటర్స్, అడ్వాన్స్ బేస్ క్యాంప్ 6,400 మీటర్స్, క్యాంప్ 1 7,100 మీటర్స్. సో మేము వెళ్ళే వే ఇట్స్ లైక్ ఎవ్రీడే 7-8 మైల్స్ వాక్ చేస్తాం. అంటే మేము స్ట్రేట్గా వెళ్ళలేం కదా, వే కంఫర్ట్ వే చూసుకోవాలి. సో ఆ తర్వాత క్యాంప్ 2 వెళ్ళాము. క్యాంప్ 3 అంటే ఇంకా డెత్ జోన్. క్యాంప్ 3ని డెత్ జోన్ అంటారు ఎందుకంటే మోస్ట్లీ పీపుల్ డై దేర్ ఓన్లీ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ లైక్ ఆక్సిజన్ సిలిండర్ ఫినిష్ అయిపోవడము, హెల్త్ ఇష్యూస్, సంథింగ్ ఎల్స్, అట్లాంటి ఇష్యూస్తోని చాలామంది చాలా డెడ్ బాడీస్ కూడా ఉంటాయి అక్కడ ఆ తర్వాత. సో క్యాంప్ 3 నుండి సమ్మిట్ టాప్ ఆ మధ్యలో చాలా డెడ్ బాడీస్ ఉంటాయి. నేను 6 డెడ్ బాడీస్ చూసాను. సో లైక్ అది ఎలా ఉండే అంటే వీ కెనాట్ రికగ్నైజ్ దట్ దే ఆర్ డెడ్ బాడీ దట్ డెడ్ బాడీస్ అని. సో క్లోత్స్ లాగా కనిపిస్తాయి అన్నమాట. అంటే ఇప్పుడు ఆ మనిషి ఇట్లా వెళ్తూ ఉంటే ఇట్లనే పడిపోతాడు. సో చిన్నగా ఒక ఏరియా అంటే దగ్గరగా ఒక దగ్గర ఉన్నట్టు కనిపిస్తుంది. సో నేను అదే క్వశ్చన్ అడుగుతూ ఉండాలి. అంటే క్యాంప్ 3 నుండి నైట్ బయలుదేరుతాము లైక్ 9, 9:30, 10 అరౌండ్ ఆ టైంలో స్టార్ట్ అవుతాము. మార్నింగ్ కల్లా రీచ్ అవుతాం ఓన్లీ 1 డే సమ్మిట్కి. సో ఆ 2014 ఇయర్లో May 25th ఎవరెస్ట్ పైన ఫస్ట్ అడుగుపెట్టింది నేనే యాజ్ ఎ క్లైంబర్గా. సో 6 o'clock ఎగ్జాక్ట్లీ 5:59 ఆ టైం మార్నింగ్ ఆ టైంకి నేను రీచ్ అయ్యాను. సో వెళ్ళే టైంకి ఆ మధ్యలో నైట్ టైంలో మళ్ళీ ఇంకో ఇన్సిడెంట్ ఏంటంటే వెళ్తూ ఉన్నాను మొత్తం బ్లాక్ అయిపోయింది. నా ఐస్ ఏం కనిపిస్తలేదు, అంటే కళ్ళు తిరుగుతున్నాయి. ఒక సైడ్ మౌంటైన్స్, ఇంకో సైడ్ లోయలు ఉన్నాయి. సో కూర్చోడానికి అక్కడ వే ఉండదన్నమాట, ప్లేస్ ఉండదు. సో ఓన్లీ వే వెళ్ళడానికి మాత్రమే ఒక పర్సన్ మాత్రమే వెళ్ళగలడు. సో నేను చెప్పొద్దని మళ్ళీ నాకు అది వామ్ థింగ్స్ చేసుకున్నప్పుడు ఆ విషయం గుర్తుకొచ్చింది.
Yeah,
okay.
So I asked Sir Shepa to I want to sit for some time. Then he said there is no place to sit here. We have to walk a little more and then we'll get place and we can check what's happening. Then Velta undali. Then we got some place to sit. Then he checked my oxygen cylinder. It was finished. So we have extra ones, but we don't have time to check on the way. So then he immediately changed my oxygen cylinder. Then again we started walking, and I reached 25th May morning 5:59 exactly time on top. 2014. So I finished only halfway. I have to come back. Yeah. So same way coming down, but coming down is also really it's very risky, and we have to step every step. We have to put very careful, and yeah. Then the overall expedition was 52 days. Generally, it takes like 40-45 days for every climber, but it depends on weather. It depends on weather. So after that, I decided to climb. I came to know about seven summits, seven continents, highest peaks through my coach. Then I decided to climb all seven summits, all seven peaks. Then until now, I climbed six mountains and one more to go, which is in North America, Mount Denali. It is located in Alaska. So that's my next one, and obviously final one.
Wow.
So recently, thank you. So 2016, I climbed Kilimanjaro, Africa's highest peak, and then 2017, I climbed the Europe continent highest peak, Mount Elbrus. Then I climbed Mount Aconcagua, which is in South America, in 2019, and I climbed Indonesia highest peak, Mount Katens Pyramid, 2019, and Mount Vinson last month, December 26th, is my summit day. And next, North America. So this is my story, and yeah, every mountain have different difficulties. I cannot say Mount Everest is toughest, but Kilimanjaro is easy. I cannot say that because every mountain have different difficulties. For example, like Indonesia, it's completely technical climbing. It's completely different. We have to know technical training. We have to take practice. We have to do practice. We have to take training for that and everything. Yeah, it's completely different. Every mountain has different difficulties. So if you can watch my movie called Poorna in Amazon Prime. It is in Hindi, and also there is a book on my story, life story. Book name is also Poorna. It is available in Indian Amazon Prime, Flipkart, everywhere. So if you have any questions, you can ask.
What about the food you carry?
So for sleeping, we have to buy a sleeping bag. There is a sleeping bag, and we have to carry tents. We have to set up ourselves. We have to carry everything ourselves, equipment, food, everything we have to carry ourselves. We have to pull sleds, sleds and bag, like around for Denali. For North America and also for Vinson, we have to carry like around 40-50 kgs. Yeah, we have to pull sled because we cannot take porters to carry.
What about the guy who came with you? He also
completed? Anand? No, I think he climbed three peaks.
But at that time?
Yeah, he is doing some other adventure sports. I mean, he is the manager for...
He finished
from base to summit,
how many days it is?
So generally it depends on weather. Generally it takes like 40-45 days. But in 2014, weather was a little bad, so it took 52 days for every climb to all.
What about the night
climbing? For climbing, it took 52
days. No, up and down. Yeah, up and down.
How many times?
Same.
And it gets very cold in the night?
Yeah, it is like minus 50 degrees Celsius in the night.
And how do you endure the cold?
Yeah, we have a like, sleeping bag, minus 40 degrees Celsius sleeping bag.
And it has batteries in it?
No batteries. Yeah, no batteries. We cannot use. We don't use actually.
Minus why?
Minus 50 degrees Celsius.
Minus 50?
Yeah. No, sleeping bag is minus 40 degrees Celsius like that. But temperature in the night time, it goes minus 50 degrees Celsius. On top, I think it's minus 60 degrees Celsius, something else on top.
What about dangerous animals? Do you come across any animals?
No animals. Snakes? I didn't know any animals.
But when you are climbing, you didn't remember your parents at all?
No, I never thought about anyone.
I just gave a chance to the kids.
Yeah, I was telling that only. If you have passion, if you have interest, no. Yeah, chala mandi manni, you know, everyone motivates us, inspire us, but interest should be come from us.
Yeah.
Chala mandi untaru manaki encourage chese vallu, but our interest should come from us. Our interest anedi, our self-confidence,
okay, next kids side. Okay, yeah, 1 second.
The younger one, she's
okay,
smart,
yeah. So. Go ahead, Nana.
Was there a track?
Okay, next. What is the question?
If there is a road, everyone can go and climb.
Why did she have to carry?
Malak.
Louder.
Why did you have to carry?
Carry things.
Yeah. Food items or?
So, normal food to tindamu. Normal food like, not rice, but like American food, something else like that.
Okay, backside. Yeah, stand up question. Speak loud, confidently, okay?
What inspired you to climb Mount Everest?
So, actually, I want to tell about that. Actually, my inspiration is my background. And also, Praveen Kumar sir is my role model. And many in our India, many people like think girl cannot do anything, you know. Selected to climb Mount Everest, then I decided to prove this is the right way that I can prove girls can do anything. Then I think my background.
Girls, come on, claps. Yeah, Prem, okay. Yeah, okay, let's go right side and we can come back left. Okay, Prem.
Since you have all these experiences,
guys, please.
What kind of professions he wants to choose in the future with all these experiences?
Professions? It's their interest. I cannot.
What kind of profession you want?
My profession.
Other than this, what kind of profession?
So, yeah, this is my it's like hobby, climbing mountains and everything. But my real life goal was to become IAS officer.
Wow.
I want to serve like Praveen Kumar sir, and many other people are serving our country and local poor people. So I want to help for them. Poorna have to help them. I mean, I want to help each and everyone. Poor people like me.
Okay, let's give the chance to kids. Okay, go ahead. Stand up and ask confidently, okay?
Have you ever solo climbed a mountain?
No, I would say solo climbing is a risky climbing, but I didn't went like solo. I always went with a group, yeah. But it's dangerous to go solo, to climb solo.
Okay, next boy.
How many hours did you train in order to go to Mount
Everest? For Mount Everest?
Yeah.
Yeah, every day, like 3 hours in the morning and evening, like 1-2 hours. Yeah. 3 months.
Total 3 months, okay.
There are 7 summits to climb, right?
Yeah, there are many other mountains to climb, but yeah, my target is to climb all continents' highest peaks, but I don't know if maybe I'll climb other mountains also after 7 summits. I'm not decided. Yeah.
Okay, next, last, Rishita.
Louder.
Same mountain. I think maybe.
Okay, Lakshmi. Yeah.
We started watching your movie, and I just finished writing the first 40 minutes. But do you think the Indian government played a really important role about that your achievement? I know the Praveen sir, like looking at the movie, I know that he really helped you, but who financed the whole project?
Oh, financial support. So for Everest, financial support, yeah, actually I went as a AP girl, and AP government sponsored me. And yeah, rest of the mountain, I don't know, financial, Praveen sir and Shekhar sir, they'll take care about financial background, whatever. But for Everest climbing, yeah, AP government sponsored for me. I climbed as a AP girl, but I came back as a Telangana girl. Yeah.
Telangana in June 7th. Okay, one more question, last. Yeah.
And also one more question. Do you think that you will continue training kids in mountain
like academy?
Do you want to train somebody else? Do you want to train kids or next generation?
Yeah, maybe, they're planning something for me. My coach, they are planning something for me. Yeah, I'm interested to train many other kids. Yeah, I'm interested. Maybe I can do that also.
Okay, next.
After 7 summits.
What's your diet?
There is nothing special, just like normal diet, nothing special.
No sweets,
right?
Sorry?
No sweets. Yeah, I love sweets. I like chocolates.
Suppose, are there any Olympic opportunities for mountaineers?
Olympic opportunities?
For mountaineers.
I don't know.
We should explore.
Yeah, maybe. Sure, I'll do that.
Okay, next boy. Yeah. Guys, please.
What was the scariest moment
climbing Mount Everest?
Scariest part?
Yeah.
Scariest moment.
Moment. Oh, okay. Moment. So, when I saw dead body, I got fear when I climbed rock in Bongir, and after that, after my rock climbing training, I completely, forgot about fear and all that. And again, after long time, I feel really, again my legs started shivering and
until I reach on top, I just feeling, you know, if I get that situation, what will happen? You know, I thought everything. Yeah, I think that was the most, how could I explain? Yeah, that was the most scariest part for me when I saw dead body.
So after your first experience, you're fearless with all the other five climbers.
Can you repeat it again?
After your first climbing, right? Mm. You did the Everest.
Yeah.
Did you become fearless and more experienced?
Yeah, of course. You know, now I always like, I don't get fear to do anything, but everyone get fear to start. That first step is really important and jabta, because that first step take you to the destination. That first step is very important. So aa roju nen bongir lo bayapadi unte aa first step nen teeskokapoyi unte I cannot reach on top of the mountain rest and I cannot do all this. So if I get fear Mount Everest paina nen bayapadi undi, like I feel I don't want to do more mountain climbing, and okavela nenu bayapadi unte I cannot do all this mountain climbing, right? So yeah, I can do anything now.
Which is the most difficult of these six, and when is the date for Denali? Do you have a set date?
No.
Is it challenging to descend also? Like, we always talk about ascending, but descending also.
Descending is also, it's very dangerous, like more than climbing up. Descending is very dangerous more than climbing.
But we become more faster than climbing up?
Yeah.
So,
yeah. And if, generally, to climb, for example, Vincent, it took like 6 days to reach on top. 5 days to reach on top and 2 days to come down. Actually, generally we'll do like okoka camp ki ante return lo vachetappudu we'll directly come to we'll skip two camps anamata ante.